Hey guys, it's your girl Jahira Maravilla. Don't forget to subscribe to Jahira Maravilla TV. I love you guys so much. Thank you for staying in tune with my show, Jahira Maravilla TV on YouTube. Yes, you guys are the best. Thank you for tuning in. I love you guys so, so very much. Mwah. Hey guys, it's your girl Jahira Maravilla. Today we're going to be talking about Princess Diana. But don't forget to please subscribe to this channel on Jahira Maravilla TV. And don't forget to hit that like button. Diana was a real princess. Yes, she was a real princess, but she was our princess. She was the queen for us. She took over the queen's position because she had so much attention from everybody. Everybody loved Diana. And I think a lot of people feel uncomfortable with that love, especially the love that she had for her two boys. She was such an amazing mother. Esta mujer era lo más humilde que había con sus hijos, porque ella lo adoraba a sus hijos. Y era una buena, buena madre, una madre ejemplar. Esos niños adoraban a su mamá. Su mamá era una mujer que era una princesa, pero para nosotros ella era la princesa del mundo. Todo el mundo la adoraba a ella y todo el mundo la apreciaba a Diana. Y la sí seguimos apreciándola, porque al fin del día ella se murió, pero no murió en nuestros corazones. Diana is a woman that she was so strong with what she had dealt with, especially in her marriage. Remember, she said that in her marriage there were three. Because he was always with his ex-girlfriend. He never left her. He never broke up with his ex-girlfriend. And on their wedding day, his ex-girlfriend was in their wedding. Can you believe that? That suffering and that shame that you have to go through with certain gentlemen? He is a king now. He's a future king. But at the end of the day, I feel like the public will never forgive him for ruining our princess's life. Because at the end of the day, she left with another man. She was with Jordi Lafayette when she died, but she left and she was with him because she was despechada con lo que el prince le había hecho a ella. Ella amaba al prince, ella los adoraba, pero como él le pegó, él estaba con otra mujer y le pegó, tú sabes que ella fracasó ahí porque ella lo amaba y sufrió una depresión muy, muy, muy fuerte, que lo escribió en el libro, que ella no entendía por qué él estaba con ella cuando ella le estaba dando dos niños a él. Se embarazó dos veces para ver si él quería cambiar, que si él iba a cambiar por sus hijos, y nunca. Por eso te digo a ti, el hombre no cambia, el hombre no, los hijos no amarran hombre, los hijos no amarran hombre, porque el hombre que quiere estar con otra mujer va a estar con otra mujer, mis hijas. Aprendan eso. Y otra cosa, esta mujer era una mujer inteligente, era bella. Y no es que dije que él la eligió ella de una y no, de miles. No, él la conocía a ella desde niña. Ella era elegida para ser para su mujer desde niña. Por eso que that arranged marriage stuff, I don't like it. So once the paparazzi started attacking her and started going after her, and she liked it at the beginning. It was nice for her. But once they started, it was too much. It was too much. She started rebelling against them. But her last days, it was different. Beautiful energy that we received from Diana, that she wanted to smile for the crowd, that she wanted to be, and she wanted to, you know, like, she wanted to be showing, like, the fact that she was a real life princess. Like, she wanted to show the world that. But once she decided that she was gonna be over, like, she was gonna leave him, it was a wrap, because at the end of the day, it was just really, really, really hard for her to continue in this situation and this lie that she was living. She wanted to tell the world. Like, the queen knew that everybody loved Diana, and Diana was not gonna sit there and just sit and take whatever they said, just like Meghan Markle. Like, young Meghan Markle had to totally disown them because of their rules and their regulations, and that I feel like Diana got tired of it. Diana got tired of playing the princess while her husband wanted to be the playboy. And that's a no-no. Mm-mm. And the queen feels like things should always go her way because she's a queen. And Diana got tired of it. And that's when she really fell in love for Dodi Lafayette, a multi-billionaire in his own time. He was one of the richest men in his own time. As a matter of fact, que le daba competición a la queen, porque tenía tanto dinero, el papá era rico. Y él era, decían playboy, porque siempre tenía las mujeres de Victoria's Secret, tenía mujeres por aquí, pero cuando se enamoró de Diana, se enamoró de los hijos de Diana y estaba súper enamorado. Y eso le molestó mucho, mucho, mucho a la reina. Y tú sabes, cuando le molesta a la reina, hay problemas. Entonces, después de ahí, as you can see, everything is down here from there. Like, as much as she tried with the book, bringing it out, as much as she tried to tell people what was going on in her marriage, as much as she tried to tell them that they were trying to keep him away from her kids, ella se sentía todavía con la depresión al no poder ver sus hijos como ella quería ver sus hijos. Y ella, con tanto dinero, poder vacacionar como ella tenía que vacacionar con sus hijos. O sea, era un puro infierno para ella. No podía vivir una vida normal. Y eso no era lo que ella sabía, que lo que ella, she was signing up to, but she was like, that's all you can see, that money is not enough. I love you guys. Stay tuned to Jahar Maravilla TV. Rest in peace, Princess Diana. We love you, the princess of the world. Don't forget to hit that bottom button and subscribe. Thank you so much for tuning in. I love you guys so much. Mwah.